So I was scrolling through Pinterest the other day, looking for some design inspiration, and I came across these custom-made newspapers for all sorts of occasions, from weddings, anniversaries, birthday parties, and other special events. I don't know about you, but I would love to hang something like this around as poster art. That is why I decided to create a template like this in Photopea and share with you the whole process in this video. So without further ado, head over to photopea.com and create a new project. Choose any size you want. Just make sure it's vertical and the DPI is 300 and click Create. This first step is optional, but it will allow us to lay out the elements easily. So go to View, Add Guides, choose inches for units and input the same values as you see here. Click OK once you're done. Pick the line tool in the options, make sure shape is selected, fill color is black, no stroke, the size depends on your document. I went with 5 pixels. Drag the cursor across the document to draw the first line while holding the shift key to make the line perfectly horizontal. Duplicate the line shape. Press Ctrl plus J. With the copy now active, press Ctrl plus Alt plus T for transform. In the options at the top, make sure the chain link icon is disabled and set the height field to 200%. We want to separate those two shapes, so pick the Move tool and nudge the shape upwards by pressing the up arrow key several times. Zoom in to see what you're doing. Next, we'll add the newspaper name. This is called nameplate in editorial lingo. Pick the Type tool, open the font list, and choose the font you like. Click near the top of the document and write your favorite newspaper name. Since I'm going for a traditional vintage style newspaper, I went with a black letter style font. If you like this style as well, I will have some font suggestions below in the description. Pick the Move tool and drag the text to the center. Rely on the red guide to help you with that. I'll go ahead and choose another font. You don't have to do this if you like the one you picked. Adjust the text size, make sure the type tool is active. Go near the size field, the cursor will change to a double arrow. Drag the cursor to the left to make the text smaller or to the right to make it bigger. I see some space left here, so we'll move the line shapes upwards a bit. Next, click on the first shape, then press Ctrl plus J to make another copy. With the Move tool selected, press the down arrow button several times to create some space, which we need shortly. Now, pick the Type tool and zoom into the document so we can see what we're doing here. Click somewhere between those two lines, set the text size between 30 to 50 pixels. Now, firstly we'll add the newspaper tagline. To change the font, open the font list, and since there is so much fonts in there, I will filter them out to show only the ones I'm looking for. To do so, click the little hamburger icon and check all and check only one of the font style. For small text, serif and sans serif work best. Use the Move tool to center the tagline in the middle.
Now
Next, we'll add the weather forecast to the left. I will use some shapes and text for this. Pick the custom shape tool. In the custom shapes list, input cloud in the search field to find the cloud shape. Pick the line shape again, draw a small line under the cloud shape, pick the move tool and drag it while holding the alt key. Do this twice and you should have a rain icon by now. Next, pick the type tool again and write a short weather forecast. Drag another horizontal guide from the top, which will use to align the text layers. On the right, we'll add the date of the event. Use the move tool to align it with the other text layers. Now it's time to add the headline. Pick the type tool again, drag across the document to create a text box, write your desired headline. Adjust the size so the text is as big as the document width. Open the font list and change the font. Usually, slab serif fonts are used for headlines to make them stand out, so I will use the filter feature to filter out the other font styles. Add another text box below for the secondary headline. Please note that all of this is optional, so feel free to skip the parts you don't want to include. Open the character panel. There you can adjust the text size, the space between each character known as tracking, and the space between lines also known as leading. You can also use the paragraph panel to adjust text alignment, line indent, etc. If you need to change the font, open the font list again and use the filter to find what you want faster. Use the move tool to adjust the text placement if you need to. Next, go to File, Open and Place, then open an image you like to be shown in the paper. Use the Move tool if you need to adjust its placement. And depending on your document size, image format, portrait, or landscape, you might not be able to add any further details. For me, there is some empty space to the right, which I'll use to add some more details. If your photo leaves any empty space below or to the side, use it to add some details about your own event. Since this is just a template, I'll simply copy some text from this website. So grab the type tool and add the text box and paste your text in there. As you can see, the text is barely legible and the space between each line is way too big. If your text looks the same, open the character panel, increase the text size and decrease the leading value. It's recommended to have both the size and leading values set to the same. If you're zoomed in, zoom out to see the full picture so we will know what changes you need to make. I think this text needs to be a little bigger. Once you get the text to look the way you want it, it's time to add a small line that will separate the text from the edge. So pick the line tool and draw a line below the text, hold the shift key to make it perfectly horizontal. This step is optional as well. It's going to add a small touch of realism to the paper. So open and place an image of a barcode. You can get a random one from Google Images or try an online barcode generator. Remember to organize the layer stack if things get confusing. Hold Ctrl to select multiple layers one by one, or hold Shift to select a range of layers. You can put all the text layers in a folder. You can do so by pressing Ctrl plus G. Same thing for the line shape layers, and you can leave the images outside if you want. We forgot to add a title to this article, so click right at the beginning of the first line and press Enter or Return to make room for the title and the author. Go ahead and write something for the title and who the writer is. Again, you can open the character panel if you need to make adjustments. I will link an old vintage paper texture below. Download it and open and place it into the document through the file menu. scale it to fit the canvas. Next, we use the layer style window to make the paper texture show through all the other elements, starting with the text layers. Double click on each layer to open the blending options. In the blend this section, hold the Alt key and drag the bottom right slider inwards to around 240. If you zoom in, you can see the texture shows through the text, which makes it look like the ink has started to fade. And do the same for all the other text, shapes, and images. If your barcode image has white in it, change its blend mode to multiply, which gets rid of the white areas. Lastly, we'll add some additional effects to the main image to make it look a bit more distressed. So go to Filter, Noise, Add Noise. Set the amount to 5%, distribution to Gaussian, and check monochromatic. Again, go to Filter, Pixelate, Color Halter. Set the amount to 4 pixels and set all the angles to 40 degrees. In the Layers panel, double click the little gear icon next to the color halftone effect to bring up its blending options. Set the blend mode to soft light. This will make it interact with the image below. The result is a cool newspaper poster art that anyone with a bit of time on their hands or a little patience can make and offer as gifts to family and friends. If you don't want to go through this tutorial, I will share the link to this newspaper template that you can access and use with your own details, which will save you a lot of time. The template is linked in the description box. I hope you got some value from this tutorial. If you did, I really appreciate a thumbs up to help spread the word. Thank you very much for watching, and I will hopefully see you in the next one.